O'Mara, Radio Entertainment. You can listen to The Mike O'Mara Show at MikeO'MaraShow.com.
Let's get started.
It's The Mike O'Mara Show with Mike O'Mara, Oscar Santana, and Robb Spiewak. Now, here's Mike.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. Good to be back after the anniversary odyssey, as I like to call it. Welcome to the Mike O'Mara Show. We are enjoying our second decade of the show that has become a daily routine for thousands of listeners in great places like Provincetown, Massachusetts. P-Town.
P-Town.
Is that what you call it?
Zanesville. What?
You call it P-Town?
I believe it was referred to up there as P-Town.
Okay.
Yeah, P-Town.
I've partied it.
Zanesville, Ohio. Sandston, Virginia. Joliet, Illinois, where the prison is.
Yes.
Rice Lake, where Jake and Elwood were.
Exactly. Joliet, Jake, and Elwood Blues.
I thought Rick and Morty were from there.
I don't know who they are.
And then there's also that Shakespearean play, Romeo and Joliet.
Mm.
Rice Lake, Wisconsin, and the Republic of Singapore.
Yes.
Which I saw Crazy Rich Asians, and I'd like to go to Singapore someday.
I like
it. It looks
movie.
Like it would be fun. It would like be really, really fun. So thank you to Oscar and to Robb for covering for me yesterday while I drove back from the Panhandle after my anniversary weekend. It was an 8-hour drive, so that was why I was not here yesterday.
We were guessing, is it the 11th anniversary?
Yeah, we'll go with that.
You gotta know, it's your anniversary.
No,
hey,
you don't
Carla.
Have to. I used
Carla,
to think
you can
you
hear
to.
Me? What was that, our 11th or our 12th?
I think it's
our 12th. It was our 12th
oh,
anniversary.
Oh, a dozen, cousin. That's good.
Yeah, our 12th anniversary. And I went up there with my mother-in-law and my son. So we had a house up there in the Panhandle for three nights, actually. Friday night, Saturday night, and Sunday mm-hmm. night. Came back. And it was, you know, the nice thing about getting out of the house once in a while is that things tend to happen. You see different things that you've never seen before. Things you meet different people that you've never met before. You bump into circumstances, maybe something you've never tried or an area you've never seen.
Well, culturally,
it's nice.
Mike,
yes.
if I recall, that there are three like world famous Rivieras. There is the French Riviera. There is the Mexican Riviera, and there is the Florida Riviera.
The redneck Riviera.
That's how I've heard it referred to, yes. Mm-hmm.
The we weren't probably quite as far. We were 80 miles east of Pensacola.
Okay.
So we were in the Panhandle. We were near what is called Panama City. That's the area where some of the hurricanes have hit. What's that?
Spring break capital of Florida.
Yeah, we didn't, and we were, I want to say we were just past that, because we were in a sleepy little town called, what?
I was going to say, that's why I didn't see you on TRL this weekend.
Yeah.
Because you weren't actually at
remember La Vela?
Yeah, exactly.
The candle.
It was very family oriented. It was very quiet. And, you know, and so tragically white.
Really?
It just was. Yeah. Carla hit me to that early on.
Well, unless you go to Miami, isn't it? I mean, isn't it known just for being very white?
Maybe it is, Oscar. Yeah, yeah. Maybe it is.
There's nothing wrong with that, by the way.
No, and I'm not talking about that there was a total lack of diversity. It seemed like where we were was, a lot of young people with families. And I shouldn't be bothered by the fact that I'm seeing these men with 29-inch waists with all the perfect Zoolander haircuts.
Sweet.
You know, with their babies and everybody looking that
like
way.
A fit
but it's
dad.
Like, oh, but when my wife looked at
me more than that,
a fit dad is disgusting to me.
Yeah,
it's totally
oppressive.
Annoying.
Yeah,
like, you know,
he's definitely living off of his wife because someone's got to work,
right?
Mm-hmm. It was interesting.
That's the feeling I have.
So it was a nice trip. On our way there, before you get to these little bastions of merrymaking and holiday, you drive through Real America. I like to call it Real America.
Was it a lovely drive? Because I mean, there are drives that are very pleasant.
No, it was not. It was not.
Florida's,
I was hoping. I always think in this state that you're going to drive through an area where you go town to town to town, and you get to look out and see. You don't.
Yeah.
In order
That's New
to
England.
get in order. Well, that's not even New England. Can you do that all the time? I would love it. No, coastal areas.
I beg to differ. Driving up to Maine.
Route 1 in Maine might be an exception to the rule.
Like from Portland to where you have your place. That's a beautiful drive if you take the coastal road,
but it takes too long. And you're not. If you've got an 8-hour drive, it's going to take you 12 hours because you're going to have to go in the little
zigzags.
We can't do that. So it's a lot of pine trees. And driving all day long.
You and I and Oscar shared a vehicle once as we drove to Florida. And the one lasting memory I had from Florida as we were getting closer was crumbling infrastructure.
Yeah.
I saw a lot of...
Even downtown Orlando wasn't
that great.
I think the roads were good. And I think there wasn't a lot to see. I've driven so many miles. I really have. Even when I go on a trip by plane, I drive.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like to see the world.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, a lot of miles. And really, a lot of it is, you know, you're not amused the whole time. You're driving through rural areas. And all I know is that when we got close to our final destination, there were not one... But two altercations that I witnessed. One occurred as we got very close and we realized, I believe it was my son who had not brought a bathing suit. Well, we're going to a beach destination. So
Did he think it was a nude beach?
No, he didn't.
Okay. Because I didn't know if he handled his own.
He did hear Riviera.
Well, you know, he's old enough to handle his own packing.
Maybe he thought you were going to the French Riviera.
Look. But all shtick aside,
yes,
we had to pick up some stuff. And there was, as there always is, a Walmart that was
fantastic. You
know, somewhere in the Panhandle region. At the Walmart, this was the minor one, there was a father at self-checkout.
Mm.
There was a father, son, and I got some gym shorts. Because I wanted to look my best.
Sure.
No, because we were going to be doing a lot of bike riding, and I wanted to, wear the right. I didn't bring anything but golf shorts. And
so you wanted to be prepared
and look good.
Yes. As a gift, you were traveling with two ladies, and you love to give.
I ended up not wearing the gym shorts at all on the trip. They made their way back with their Walmart tag on.
You could return them, I'm sure, to any Walmart for a full cash refund.
I'll use them at some point if they fit well and they're comfy. That's what you normally, when I'm doing a long bike ride, that's what I wear.
Yes.
So anywho, at the self-checkout, Mrs. O'Mara and my son were somewhere else in the store.
Yes.
And I didn't know where they were, so I was just going ahead and checking out. And the son and the father were like, you know, when you, and it sounded, I caught just a little bit of it because you don't want to stare.
No.
But it's like, well, when are you doing that? I said, I don't know when I'm doing it. I told you that, Daddy. I told you to get down at Daddy. And I hear, it's like, I'm going out there. I'm going to go. And the son, all I see is what appeared to be the son walks off. And walks out of the self-checkout and walks out of the store.
Okay.
The father, I have no idea what the relationship, but it appeared to be father and mother behind.
Yeah.
And he says, he is driving me and top of his lungs, the F word, effing crazy. Such an effing jerk.
Mm.
And I'm just like going, I said, y'all have a good day now. You hear? And then.
This shocks me that they would have chosen self-checkout. Was there a full service option available?
Well, sure, there's a full service option available. I didn't know why they chose
it. Faster.
And I was scanning two pairs of shorts because I like to dress for success. Mm-hmm. And so I'm scanning my Russell athletic wear.
Russell.
Shorts.
Russell.
That I believe some people wear to dine out, you know, because
of course.
There's nothing quite like an elastic waistband.
And you're in Florida. Do what you want.
Yeah.
Well, lots of shorts. And then there was a gas stop. Now, at the gas stop was something that was much more disturbing.
Okay.
I was where I'm usually sitting. I'm in the Aunt Edna passenger side. Of the car.
Pointing at things as you drive by them, right?
What's that?
You point at things as you drive by them. That's your job in the passenger.
Look at that. Look at that. And are you coming in? Nope.
No, I'm going to stay here.
And so I stayed in the car, and then I hear,
you're the beauty, and you're the idiot.
And I roll the window down to see. And at this point in time, there appeared to be a parental handoff going on.
Okay.
Because there was a woman in a sport utility vehicle with a baby. She had handed it to a gentleman. And the gentleman said something that was, F y'all, y'all, F all y'all, F, it was... It was
that sounds F, about right.
You know, it is for this.
F you all, F you all, effing mother effers.
I hate to put this on Pony, but I think
yes,
in the interest of a proper historical record, I think you need to say it.
Fuck y'all, motherfuckers.
That sounds about right.
Believe I have that absolutely perfect.
I believe
it's and that perfect. Was it. And that was it. And it was but it was right as we were making our way into where we were going to stay, and I posted about it because I said, well, this is, I just hadn't witnessed a lot of this. Yeah. It was, you know, nothing really violent, but there was, you're driving north to go south. Get it?
Yep.
You're driving up to where you're closer. I'm closer to Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia than I am to, you know, my home in Florida. That's where we are. That's the part of the state where we are. And then all of a sudden, we went over this little bridge and suddenly we were in, immaculate, privilege land.
Yes.
And it was very, very nice. And
when you experienced the second altercation, the one with the alleged baby handoff
at the gas station, much more of a kind of an outburst, much briefer, but much more, hey, what's going on with that?
Was it
then he got into his truck and drove away and didn't like spin the wheels.
Maybe he did a little.
I'm just in the passenger side, like an old man going.
Yeah.
Was it a name brand gas station?
Doop, 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 doop.
Was it a name brand gas station or was it like Pilot?
Well, probably could have been a Pilot.
Pilot?
Could have been a Pilot. There are a lot of Pilots.
Yeah.
It's interesting.
I will tell. Yeah.
You get like it. We have similar paths in life, but different viewpoints. We're on the fourth floor here in D.C.
Mm-hmm.
And not to take it away
major from... Major metropolitan
yes,
area.
Yes. Yeah, happening.
And you're looking at a major intersection.
We'll go with that.
I will see drunkards coming out of all the bars, people fighting. This is around 6, 7 p.m. Saturday. They've been day drinking all day, especially with college football back in play.
Right, sure. You're talking about a street scene.
Yes. What in a street scene, like, hero...
You just keep walking and it's no big deal.
Well, I'm not calling 911 unless someone gets hit by a car, right?
Yeah.
Well, I'm not either.
Yeah, but
I'm,
if you're in a gas station, you may be a witness to a crime.
Could be.
But it just was a fight. He was just angry about y'all MFers about something.
Got it.
Looked to me. You know what it looked to me? Yes. Being a divorced father?
Yes.
A father who, you know, had, his life kind of turned upside down. That's immediately the vibe I got, that there was some sort of thing going, because he was taking a kid and she was going
dropping
away.
Him
I
off.
Have no.
And who hasn't had a bad day?
Yeah.
You know?
Of course.
Yeah.
I mean, it happens.
You didn't
it happens.
Have drop offs or pickups like that with your ex-wife. I'm sure it was like cordial.
Yeah, I mean, it really wasn't that bad, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
I'm trying to, I'm really trying
go
to
go see
remember.
Daddy for second Christmas. All right, bye.
No, it was, you guys were
day.
Around that. Wait a minute, you guys were around that?
Yes.
You saw a little of that.
Yeah, so, but there, I mean, was no, there was no drama. I remember, I met her twice in passing, and she looked like she
there
was
plenty of
kids.
Drama during the breakup.
Correct, right. correct. But not afterwards.
Well, no, once you accept your reality, you you move on and you have to kind of handle that.
And there was no awkward drop-offs in my house because of my absentee father.
Yes.
It was mostly phoning.
So you didn't have exchanges?
No.
Regular
you
exchanges?
You didn't see him for like 18 years,
I could think of maybe once or twice that I like slept over at his place, because largely it was because...
What?
You didn't know this?
He would take me... We would go to the beach sometimes because we had my cousin or his cousin had a beach place. So we'd go up there for occasional weekends. But no, I never stayed with him.
Yeah. Like, this is why he's the way he is. Like HBS, with all his testosterone, rolled into his life later in life when he's already formed. This is the man he was.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I don't know why I never remembered that.
But also, I spent so much time at my grandparents' house almost every weekend and a bulk of every summer because I was working the vegetable stand.
And this sounds so sad, they raised you, basically. Did your grandparents raise you, basically?
Largely, yeah. I was there all the time. Now, I'm not trying to diminish what my mom did because my mom was awesome and
she's a working mom.
She's
a hero.
Who really was there for me all the time.
Why are you saying hero, Oscar?
Because it's a nice veiled dick move.
Is what it is.
It's so dicky. He was being dicky.
What am I?
I can tell by looking at him that he's being
dicky. The hero.
But I mean, like, I would essentially live at my grandparents' house in the summertime. It doesn't sound like that to me, Oscar.
It sounds like a wonderful lady. We all know her. We love her. Yeah, She's wonderful. But it doesn't. It sounds like both parents were kind of picked up by the grandparents, right?
They
were kind
of propped up a little bit.
Propped up.
Not in a bad way.
One parent kept him.
Yeah, that's true. And he came over. He came over every Christmas.
So he didn't have visitation.
No, you know what? I would have to look at the paperwork, but I don't think there ever was like a custody or visitation agreement. It might have been because it was so amiable. It was a very cordial divorce, but I don't know. It was never really an issue. I saw him enough, but I never like went and stayed with him.
And my daughters stayed with me
all the time, every weekend.
Like every other.
Mm-hmm.
It was like they weekends or every other weekend.
Robb was not.
No. I believe I may have been loved. No, you know what? I'll say this.
I did not expect to take this turn.
I am loved today. And perhaps it was so long ago.
You have a great relationship with both parents. Now.
Yes, they do answer my calls all the time.
Has your father ever sat down and said, son, like, you know, I was young. I just didn't know any better. Sorry, like I missed most of your childhood.
No, I don't think he did miss most of my childhood. He just... And there's nothing he would ever have to apologize for. Because, okay. I mean, if I needed him, he was there. It's just there weren't a lot of sleepovers.
Where was he then if he wasn't sleeping over? Like, when would you guys hang out?
Like I said, we would spend many weekends at the beach. He would go over there and, you know, sometimes we'd hang out like on a Sunday to go do stuff.
Oh, he'd pick you up like on a random Sunday and go
out, like Chuck E. Cheese. No, it was never Chuck E. Cheese. Other things.
Did you see him weekly?
W-E-A-K-L-Y?
I thought you knew this, Mike.
No.
I didn't. Robb, am I being honest here? Did I know this? Have we ever had this kind of discussion?
We've talked about it, yeah.
Internally, I didn't know.
But I mean, you always say I'm a product of a broken home, and we make jokes about that.
Because actually, I mean, I had one of, especially if you look at my extended family, I had one
great
of the greatest,
support system.
The greatest family support system in the world growing up.
But Dad got a free pass for many years.
Yeah,
right?
But I mean, I don't think he abused it either. I mean,
No one's saying he did that. We're just trying to build like the foundation.
The narrative of who Robb Spiewak is and why. Yeah, I didn't have a lot of time with him, like probably between, I would say,
this show.
Third grade Let's and now.
Yeah. No, he stormed back into your life when you were like 18, right?
Yeah, he was, absolutely, sure.
When you were fun.
Yeah, when I could drink.
When you weren't a responsibility.
That's right. You know what? And you know what? I might be the same way. I can't blame him for that.
Okay, that's I just didn't know that.
But, you know,
let me get back to the panhandle.
Please.
What was Father's Day like back when you were kids? I'm sorry, just one last question.
Well, I was told
some people don't want to get back to the panhandle.
I was told that Father's Day was celebrated every 4 years, like a presidential election, and that it was usually
that's what made it special.
A letter was written, and it was read on.
Is that why you're such an engaged dad? Do you think?
I don't buy into all that stuff.
That you overcompensate for what you didn't have.
I don't buy into that. I do what I like to do with my kids. I love my kids. I love
you're
being
great
with them.
Dad.
And
yeah,
so
you're like their best.
No,
friend
but I mean
dad.
you are an involved.
Yeah,
I always have been an involved father.
But I don't think that that's a reflection of that as much as it is the other stuff that was going on when I was being brought up. Because we were always up in my grandmother before she passed said the thing she was proudest of in her life. Is that her eight kids would get together and socialize outside of like being at her house. Mm-hmm. That they loved each other. They were still involved and loved each other. And that she says, that's when you know you've raised your children right. And that whole sort of social structure and that familial structure is something that even as recent as a couple weeks ago when the family got together, we talked about it. Because I was talking to my Uncle Billy, who's the oldest. He was born before World War, or right during World War II, the front of the war. I mean, so he's an older fellow now. Wisdom, a lot of wisdom on him. And I and he said,
that's because George Bailey ended up going off to war.
Well, yeah, that's Uncle Billy.
I had no idea. People don't realize that Robb is literally related to Uncle Billy.
Yeah, that's
stupid man who was responsible for Mr. Potter getting all of George Bailey's
deposits.
When I was
talking to Uncle Billy, I said, why did you put the money in the newspaper?
I don't know, George. You stupid old fool. Don't you know what this means? It means prison and bankruptcy.
And scandal.
And scandal.
No, but we said, he said, how are you handling the empty nest stuff? I said, it's going a lot better than and a lot easier than I thought it would. He says, because you've raised them right. And now you have to let them launch. And that's just the way it is. And if you've done the job building up, you do okay. So anyway, I didn't expect to go here. But yeah.
Well, someday I'd like to spend more time talking about
this.
Me
too.
Well, I'm here. Yeah. I'm here, well, I'm here almost every day.
We'll call it Robb's Couch.
Yes. Okay.
We'll have that segment on the show. So let me dive back into
We sold the couches moment. Too.
One of the great things about going away is that it doesn't always have to be me who gets into something. You know what I mean? Because I think a lot of times when you listen to people, as if something really weird happens, or even, I don't want to say something bad happens, but if something out of the ordinary happens, it's anybody that does what we do for a living, we consider it after the initial shock of it. A great example would be Oscar getting into that automobile accident. Horrible, terrible. Litigated.
Terrible.
But after the dust settled and everybody was fine, Oscar realizes he's got one hell of a story to tell on the show. And it was when we were doing our live show. So it was a big deal. So
but the show
when that happens to one of us, it's a big deal. What I'm not accustomed to is having not an immediate family member, and I consider my mother-in-law a, you know, once removed family member.
Well, it's not a blood relative
happening to my
wife.
Could
be your sister.
Yeah.
The modern family with the 3 years younger than me.
Yeah.
So this is the way it goes down. We took Michael to the beach one day, took him to a pool the next day. We're taking Michael to the pool. At this particular point, Carla's mom says she wants to go out to the grocery store and get some water. So we go to the pool. It's very brief because we've got... We've got plans that night. I think this is Sunday. This is Sunday afternoon.
Oh, so you're going to an evening mass?
We're going to a sports bar so I can watch New York Giants just be horrible.
Yes,
that was
embarrassing. And I guarantee. Ready? I guarantee the Washington football win this Thursday.
Guarantee.
Yeah, you're playing the worst team. You are playing the worst team in the NFL. A team organizationally from the top down filled with rot, filled with bad decisions and mistakes and incompetence and people taking advantage of being the number one media market and wallowing in a primordial oozing pile of goo.
But the anticipation for the game is fun.
Yes.
I can do something while we're there.
But it turns out diddly poo.
I'm Daniel Jones. I am not an animal. Giants driving. Oh, he fumbled again. Anyway, getting back to it. So she goes to the store. We go to the pool. Later, we're going to go see the game.
Okay.
And as we're making our way back from the pool, my mother says, Carla says to me, gets a text from her mom and says, when you get back to the house, do I have a story to tell you? Ooh. That's not like her. I don't expect that from her. That doesn't happen very often.
You know what? Coming from her, it almost wouldn't even be a rhetorical question. You should have replied, yes, you do.
So we're not racing back to hear this story.
No, but it's out of the ordinary. It's unexpected.
So we get back to the house. And she begins to tell the tale of going. She just went to the grocery store to get some bottled water.
That's it.
She drinks bottled water ridiculous amounts of it. Constantly, bottles all over the place, bottle. And she's constantly replenishing her supply. So here's the way the story goes. I am giving this to you secondhand, but okay. I'm going to try because I grilled her. I grilled her the following morning, Monday morning. I'm grilling her to make sure that I've got it right. Might have been Sunday evening that I'm just making sure. Let me see if I've got this straight. So here's how the story goes. She is making her way back to the car with her bottled water.
She's already made the purchase.
She sees a man who is standing at the rear door of, I think maybe an SUV, but he's standing at the rear door. And she goes off and she puts the water in the car and returns the cart to the cart corral.
Good.
Very sweet.
When she turns around, she sees this gentleman. And this gentleman is wearing what appears to be some sort of nylon spandex underwear and nothing else. And he's standing at the rear door of the car, the rear door behind the passenger, behind the driver's door.
Okay.
And she explains that she sees everything. Mm. Not that it's exposed, based on the tightness or the outline, she sees this man's genitalia. Mm.
As Robin Williams once said, pants so tight you can tell his religion.
That's what she sees.
Right.
At this particular point, she sees this, notices it. He doesn't seem to be acknowledging her. That will play into the story. And by the way, we will have a visual aid today.
Oh, yes. Oh,
fantastic.
She makes her way, closes the hatch on the car,
yep.
Makes her way around to the passenger side, to the driver's side. By this time, when she gets into the driver's seat, she looks through the window and she sees the man has now moved his way to the front of the car and he is bending over, appearing to reach for something. Mm. But she notices that his complete buttocks are exposed.
Mm. Like it's a thong-styled garment?
Thong-style, but not thong underwear. It appears to be tight satin briefs that have been purposefully pulled into the crack of his buttocks.
I understand.
And because she is a super sleuth, in my humble opinion, and doing a great job, she decides she's got to get a picture of this.
Yeah.
So she snaps off a picture. And at that moment, she said, well, I don't know if I got that picture. She's going to do it again. As she's getting ready to take the second picture, as this man's cheeks are up in the air,
yes,
she looks in his side view mirror and he is looking directly at her.
Mm. Oh, no.
As if to be presenting the buttocks for her to see.
And if he is presenting, I bet he has no problem with being photographed.
I am going to send the picture. I urge you to zoom in.
May I add,
on the picture?
Just for our audience.
Yeah.
God forbid there's a new listener listening today. Mike's mother-in-law, who is 3 years younger than Mike,
yes,
is a smoke show. She's very lovely. Very attractive. Mm-hmm. Carla is a byproduct of a smoke show, so she's a smoke show.
Well, there you go, Austin. Yeah.
When you see the picture, tell me if I got it right.
That guy is getting his kinks by showing himself off to said smoke show.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what it is.
But also, I will also add this, if I may. I think he might work out.
I mean, he's got great glutes.
Oh, I think it. Now that I'm looking at the picture, it appears. No, he doesn't work out.
That was just a joke, of course.
I believe it may be. Note in this photograph.
Yeah.
It's not the side view mirror. It's the rear view mirror. Note the position of the rear view mirror. And that's when it gets a little disturbing.
Yeah, that was purposely aimed for this shot. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I like that she's so ballsy that she's like, let's use a different word. Let me get this on film.
Yeah, exactly. Digital capture.
Now you want to get another zoom in on that photograph.
All right.
With pleasure.
And note the hair.
Let me see the hair on the guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's got a.
Those might be.
Does
implants.
That appear to be some sort of permed or even perhaps a wig?
I think
of some
it,
kind?
My first guess was implants gone
yeah,
bad.
Yeah. Like the legend of Dewey Cox.
She's got a guy
ride hard.
That
yeah. Walk hard.
At
walk
this
hard.
Point, at this point, when the eyes meet, she looks down. She's not going to look over again. Her goal is to get the car out of the parking space.
I guess so.
She explains it like this. As she begins to back out of the parking space, this gentleman begins twerking.
Oh!
Bouncing his ass yeah. up and down vigorously with his knees on the running
maybe,
board.
Maybe he was like, hey, lady, if you want a show, I'll give you a show.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. yeah.
And how would you describe the under? Do those appear to be some sort of satin briefs of some kind that are?
Yeah.
I said, were there pants around the ankles at all? No, this is what he was wearing. These are the shorts that he was wearing.
There's some fabric underneath as well.
Yeah, that appears not to be thong tight.
No. Yeah, so these are what happens is what you've got here are Richard Simmons styled
yes,
shorts.
Yes, yes,
for lack
yes,
of a
yes,
better yes, explanation,
like running shorts.
But what they've done, Mike, is a portion of them have, like you, took a trip north this yeah. very weekend.
Very but not all disturbing. Of it. Yeah. Look, all kidding aside.
No, no. All kidding aside, I agree with you, Oscar. I said this could have been a potentially very bad
awkward,
situation.
Yeah. Awkwardly bad.
Like Silence of the Lambs it, you know? Type of situation.
Yeah. yeah, very, very weird. But I mean, Silence of the Lambs, if you know, if the guy with the van was standing outside twerking with yeah. his ass in the air, you know, instead of sneaking somebody into the back of his van,
he didn't,
it was
he didn't
weird.
Turn to your mother-in-law and say, it moves the rearview mirror.
It moves the rearview mirror.
I like
or
that
else it gets the butt again.
So great.
So my question to you, is this kink, this yeah. man who is obviously has his rearview mirror positioned so he can see the reaction, is he, A, doing this because he thinks, hey, maybe this will result in something, or B, just doing this like he's probably done 1,000 times to other people in supermarket parking
I'm
lots.
Sure it
what
is.
What say you?
I say that it is in a similar vein to a flasher, but what
yep.
he's done
that's what I think.
Is he's made it legal by not really flashing.
Yeah,
you know?
It's pretty creepy, though.
It's beyond creepy, and it's wrong. Mm-hmm.
For me, nothing shocks me. Like, when you, on Nextdoor, every 25th post of a week always says, guy in trench coat, right? And even in the summer, like guy with long coat, like showing himself off.
Right.
These guys are broken. This gentleman in the picture, my opinion, is broken.
Yeah, but you can't have a trench coat in Florida because it's too hot. So he has to use
pink,
running shorts.
Get your pink satin boxers
yeah,
out and
yeah,
shove
yeah,
him
yeah.
up the crack of your
when
ass.
There's an opportunity.
Different. If he was in Wisconsin, it would be different.
This is classic. Right. This is classic flasher tradecraft.
Tradecraft.
Yes,
I think he's right.
They set up and then they strike when they and for all in fairness to Carla's mother, like it's not like you've got somebody that's not attractive sitting parking next to him.
How much do you think that has to do with it? Because if you're saying the way this is based on her look. And this just because she just rolled out of the store and this guy's
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
Do you think because now you're starting to freak me out because do you think this guy is seeing her and going, I got a plan? Or is this just could he have done this to an 85-year-old
he's
grandmother?
He's not doing it to Granny.
No,
he's not
I don't
doing that.
Okay. I disagree. I think he would do it. I think if the thrill is to
waste of a flash
to expose your ass. The target has very little to do with it, I would
so
guess.
So it could be anyone?
I would think so if he was already parked next to her. The fact that she's lovely is just gravy for him, if you'll pardon the expression.
Hey, Carla.
I think it's strategic.
Oh, Carla's taking a nap. Yeah. She's got home from work.
Well, she's got to deal with that. Her mom's being harassed at grocery stores.
I know.
Her
it's incredible. Yeah. But the whole thing at the end,
scary.
the twerking.
Oh, I'm sure. I'm sure he's got a game.
He
got
had
a game
his
book.
Victim.
He's in shape. You know? He wanted to show off.
He's got a game book. He's got a playbook.
Not in shape. That, he's not.
Mike, that.
Excuse
if you didn't
me.
Tell
that
me,
is not
if you
in
didn't
shape.
Tell me that butt was a man's butt, I'd think twice.
Hold on a second. You think that's in shape?
It's all right.
I mean, I don't know.
That take a look at it again. Note the stomach next to the right arm.
I'm not looking. I'm saying if you
that's true.
If you just showed me the shape of that rump, I might be into it. I didn't know.
I think the guy looks
him.
Like he's 265, Oscar.
From this angle, I'm just telling you.
What is Oscar's favorite angle?
It's
documented on that show.
But anyway.
I wish we could put this up and take a poll.
Well, yeah, put it up. Go ahead.
No!
Put it up at MichaelVeraShow.com.
No.
Don't need to be reported.
That's not the traffic we want.
For that nonsense.
Well, anyway.
Tony, what'd you think? Do you like it? Or something you get into if you know?
You know what? I think it's impressive work. And, you know, kudos to him for the twerking. It's a little extra touch.
There you go.
There it is. Enjoy, everybody. We'll take a short break. Come back with the homepage. You're listening to the Mike O'Mara Show, and we will be right back after that. Sorry your dad didn't spend more time with you, Rob.
That's all right. I'm glad the chance we got to meet Panhandle Paul.
Okay, good.
Jim Amato, I love your voice. It's just fantastic.
And now the sultry sounds of Jim Amato are available in one timeless collection. TNA Records is proud to present That's Amato. Listen as Jim reads some of his favorite words.
Bamboozle. Aluminum. Quinceañera. Phantasmagoria. Sheer panties.
Amato does it all. Jim's silky smooth tones sing as he reads from the Jugtown, Pennsylvania phone book.
Carpenter. Ralph.
No! Stop it! You two idiots are ruining this podcast with your stupid, silly, asinine garbage!
Rabbits, Twitch,
and Amato! Get back in line, you miserable pews!
But
you will listen to the Mike O'Mara Show! You will order a bonus show subscription by clicking the banner at MikeO'MaraShow.com! That's an order! Company dismissed!
Thank you. That's interesting.
It's nice, isn't it?
I don't know. I don't know what kind of drugs those guys are on, but it's interesting. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, everybody. This portion of our program brought to you by Liquid IV. It's still summer.
Yeah.
Whew! And we need to be proactive to keep our body fueled up in case you were twerking somewhere and hydrated so we can be our best. One stick of Liquid IV and 16 ounces of water hydrates faster and more efficiently than water alone. And it tastes great. It's delicious. Flavors like watermelon, strawberry, lemon, lime. It sounds amazing because it is. We live on Liquid IV here at TMOS because it makes us feel great and the taste can't be beat. What makes Liquid IV so effective? Cellular transport technology. CTT. It's the optimal ratio of glucose, sodium, and potassium, and it delivers water and nutrients into the bloodstream super fast. Plus, Liquid IV is on a mission to change the world. Products are being donated to hospitals, first responders, food banks, veterans, and active military. Liquid IV has donated over 11 million servings globally. Grab your Liquid IV in bulk nationwide at Costco, or you can get 25% off when you go to liquidiv.com and use the code TMOS at checkout. That's 25% off anything you order today when you get better hydration using promo code TMOS at liquidiv.com. Robb is drinking it right now.
As they are great. You know, we don't say it enough. Thank you to Liquid IV. They've been such an amazing partner. We love them.
If you look, just try this at home. Literally grab one of these packs and drink four of these with your Liquid IV. You're going to feel happier and healthier.
Yeah.
You just are.
You do better. You do better. It's good stuff.
Just don't put any pink boxer shorts on. Thank you.
From the four corners of the World Wide Web and into your digital device, it's what you need to know. This is the homepage.
Yes, it is. And we start the homepage off with some very good news. Jeff Bridges had some great news to share yesterday. His cancer is in remission. Last October, he announced he was diagnosed with lymphoma and would be starting treatment. And yesterday, he said his 9-inch by 12-inch mass is now the size of a marble. Would this be the speech? Is this
Could be. Wow. I think he kind of kept it quiet.
It's very, very strange. We'll get to another story that Rob's got after this that is not has also been kept quiet. Jeff also said he had COVID earlier this year. He caught it at the facility where he's receiving his chemo. He's feeling much better now. Up until recently, he was needing oxygen just to walk around, but thanks to the therapy, he was able to walk his daughter down the aisle at her wedding and do the father-daughter dance without the oxygen tank. Jeff will soon resume filming his new Hulu series, The Old Man. And now a horrible piece of news from the comedy community, the Saturday Night Live community, the podcast community. This broke right before we taped the show today. Norm MacDonald, one of the funniest men in the world, a guy that, you know, we use this all the time on the show.
Who did they go to war with?
the world.
We had no idea that Norm McDonald has passed away.
He was quietly, moments before the show tape.
It
broke about 20 minutes before we opened the mics. He was quietly battling cancer, apparently. And remember, about a year ago, he said that he was going to back off on touring because he couldn't do it without offending people.
Yes.
So I don't know if that was part of his strategy to stay out of the limelight, but he passed today, according to his production partner. He was 61.
A great one.
And
just a shame.
So funny. Such a funny man.
Hate to lose funny people. Mm-hmm. I really do. And
too young.
That's just really a lot of good comedy in that guy, and just a unique comedy. Just the delivery, and we always talked about it. A marvelous stand-up, marvelous anchor. I loved his anchoring.
Oh, so good on Weekend Update. He was also one of the elite community to drop an F-bomb on Saturday Night Live. Attaboy, Norm.
This next story, I might be the number one shill for Jackass. I seriously might be the guy because I read every Jackass story. I don't know why, and I don't know why I've waited this long. I probably was somebody when they first came out, I was like, oh, those rowdy guys, like that. I don't know why. Maybe I hear about the amount of medical bills they've sustained, and you go back and look at the old stuff.
Yeah.
It's just interesting. This might be hard to believe. Here's the way the story starts, but there actually were some Jackass scenes that were a bit too graphic to show on TV.
Oh.
On the latest episode of Hot Ones, Truth or Dab, Steve-O described three scenes that were cut. And they all involve Johnny Knoxville.
Of course.
Who really, he's the big star of Jackass, mm-hmm. but he's probably also the one who put his ass on the line more than any of them. Steve-O said in a scene called Box Downstairs, quote, Johnny just got in a box. They tucked in some pillows around him, taped it up, and rolled it down a huge flight of cement stairs.
Oh, my God.
And it was violent as hell. That's it.
That's
it? I don't know why they had to cut it, but maybe he got messed up.
Well, not just that. It's like, that is funny, but they have such funnier prank. It just gets cut from the movie. They're like, that's not crazy enough.
Yeah.
The second scene is when Johnny shot himself with a .38 caliber Smith & Wesson revolver.
Whoa.
And the third scene, did you ever hear about him
the revolver,
shooting himself?
No. I've heard of this scene, and Standards in Practice? What's that?
It'd be called Standards in Practice.
Yeah. They said, no effing way are you putting that out. If kids die doing that, it's on us.
The third scene is when Johnny Knoxville got hit by a car. Steve-O said, quote, he said, I'm Johnny Knoxville, and I'm going to get hit by a car real soon. And then a car just came flying. They're such idiots.
They really
And then a car
are.
Just came flying. He went through the windshield, rolled over. I don't know what that... They asked him, what were you thinking when you got hit by a car? And his answer was, I wore two pairs of jeans so that I'd be safe. They are promoting this next one. Jackass Forever, is that the movie that's coming out?
Yeah.
They're doing such
it's
a great job.
It's got great
just,
reviews. Does it really? Reviews, yeah. Now, if
we'll
that's
see.
Your type of comedy, I'll watch all of them, not in the theater, but at home, because I need to collect all of them. I need to see every stunt.
Jackass Forever drops in February.
February.
We'll see it there.
All right. We're a funny country, we in the United States.
Funny,
whether you like it or not. Do I amuse you? Do I make you laugh? Whether you like it or not, Cops is an American institution, and it's coming back. The show was canceled last year, along with the A&E show Live PD, due to national outrage in the wake of the George Floyd murder by a police officer. But Fox News is bringing back the Cops show on its Fox Nation streaming service beginning October 1st. Meanwhile, Live PD host Dan Abrams says he and the producers are doing everything possible to bring their show back, and he claims there's, quote, significant interest within the industry. Bad boys.
I'd watch it.
Yeah, I didn't watch it when it was on, so I'm not going to watch
it. Why didn't you like it?
It's unpleasant.
I watched it drinking one night with a bunch of people. We had a bet on each segment whether the guy would have a shirt on or not. And it was fun. It was a lot of fun.
Well, if you make it into a sporting thing, then now I'm in.
Well, you can gamble on anything. Uh-huh. People are now huffing the fumes from onions because they think it kills the coronavirus.
Well, I've heard this.
We're bright people.
I've heard this in my mom in the early early times of COVID, she would get these like memes from people that were not bright about taking a hair dryer and putting a hair dryer into your nostrils. I was like, what is going on?
Now, this was from your brothers?
No, sister? This is like from her friends from El Pueblo.
Oh, that means the
memes.
Pueblo.
Memes claiming it's true have been circulating on Facebook, especially in Asia. They say to cut an onion in half, cup it against your nose and mouth, and take a series of deep breaths. But there's zero evidence. Really? Zero evidence that it
not
actually
even one,
works?
Not even one evidence?
It's gained so much traction that the news outlet AFP felt the need to debunk it. Mm. One doctor they talked to said it's more bogus misinformation that could actually be harmful to the general public.
But it's great for Big Onion. Do you think it was started?
Cry.
Was it started by the onion industry?
Maybe.
Yeah, to sell onions.
But also, people are so desperate they'll try anything.
Yeah, it's true. It's
gonna make you cry. You're gonna cry. All right. So, do you want to hear about the? I mean, I'm gonna skip the Florida today. I'm gonna go to Sioux Falls.
Sioux Falls.
Okay.
Little something something because we're running late.
Okay.
And we've got Mac McIntosh coming up.
Mac, yes. McIntosh. Okay.
A Sioux Falls man faces burglary charges after police found him after hours at a bar drinking a beer. Police say 53-year-old, his name, what was his name here? It doesn't say his name, does it? Well,
does
anyway.
It matter?
He was 53, and he was arrested about 5:30 a.m. Hey, that's cool. He's 53, and he's arrested at 5:30.
Coincidence.
The man was charged with first-degree burglary and booked into the Minnehaha County Jail.
Which one?
Minnehaha.
Oh, that's a good jail.
Yeah, welcome to Lake Minnehaha. An alarm notified police of a possible occupant at the bar. Police said they found the man walking around the establishment drinking a beer.
Mm.
Police were unsure how the man got into the bar, but they said forced entry was not a factor. Well, then, oh, maybe he hid in the men's stall then.
It could be, though.
Eh? You betcha, yeah. Yeah, he was kind of funny looking, you know? So what do you mean funny looking? I don't arrange that kind of thing.
Only he didn't say thank you.
So there you go. End of story. Yeah, you got that right. There we go.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, Minnehaha. Thanks a lot for coming. I just stayed there and hid in the stall, you know, so I could get a free beer after hours. Yay.
I ate at Minnehaha. They made an onion volcano right on the hibachi.
Yeah, and then you huffed it.
I did. Not
and you'll never get COVID.
Never been better.
We'll be back with Mac McIntosh.
Hello there. I know it might seem counterintuitive and maybe even silly to take advice from a promo, but I'm something of a famous radio pitchman. So this is something you can believe in. My mother always said that you can trust a man with facial hair. And if you have any confidence at all in the wisdom of a mother, it's time to stare at my drawn-on mustache and heed my words. Do you need a little more laughter in your dark, secluded, lonely life? Sure you do. You need the Mike O'Mara Bonus Show. For pennies a day, the Bonus Show will take you from zero to hero. And all the ladies will be digging your scene. Grab it at MikeO'MaraShow.com. You'll be glad you did, and we'll be glad for you. Buy the Bonus Show and make me smile. A big, flashy, fake, insincere smile. You earned it, Pajango.
Thank you. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show.
Thank you.
Whether you're camping in the woods or at a backyard get-together or a backyard get-together, there's nothing like a roaring fire to bring you back to what matters. Put down your device. Dig the warmth, the brilliance, the connection. Those fireside moments ground you in what it means to be human. And we are getting into that time of the year where a solo stove is so wonderful for your backyard to sit there and just chill out.
Yeah.
It creates story-worthy moments. Fireside fumes not included. The stainless steel construction is designed to regulate airflow and burn more efficiently. With so little smoke, you'll wonder how there's so much fire. No campfire smell either on your clothes and hair, and nothing left but ultra-fine ash for easy cleanup. From camp stoves to backyard bonfires, Solo Stove products are portable and built to last, easy to light with a few bits of starter. Your fire's ablazing in minutes, and Solo Stove is so confident in their products, they give you a lifetime warranty for every single purchase. No one needs a reason to gather around the fire. Solo Stove just took away any reason not to.
True story, this past weekend, they are so portable. They actually come with a bag.
Yes.
I bagged up my Solo Stove, went and saw our buddies Doug and Haiti. We had a fire on their patio with my Solo Stove.
Oh, wow.
You went all the way to Haiti to see your friend Doug?
No. I went to Doug. Haiti is the wife you see.
Oh, it sounded like you said you went to see your friend Doug in Haiti.
No, I did the volunteer work the previous weekend.
Okay. Now you can get $10 off when you use promo code TMOS at checkout. Just go to solostove.com. And remember, you get $10 off when you use promo code TMOS. Is Mike McIntosh standing by? We don't have much time for
him. He's in the waiting room. Yes,
let him in the waiting room. Give me an update. What was the last when we checked in with him? He was moving into his new pad.
Exactly. And I believe we were going to challenge him on furnishings. Is that right, Oscar?
Yes.
About how he's going to have it furnished?
If he had moved in.
Yes.
I hear that. There he is. Ding dong.
Oh, look at this guy.
actually, that's more like me.
I wasn't going to say anything, Mike.
Hey, nice gaming chair. Really nice gaming chair.
Are you unmuted?
Unmute your mic, Mike.
Unless he's muted on our end. What's wrong with him here?
I don't know.
I heard the ding ding, that's not
us. Great. It's a great picture, though.
It's a wonderful picture of a beautiful thing.
You've got such soft skin.
Now I hear you.
Talk now.
Okay. You hear me now?
I do hear you.
Yes.
Now.
Absolutely. How are you?
I'm doing well in my new place.
Can you show us your gaming chair? I'm really
sure.
My son wants a gaming chair, so I wanted to see that. Look at that.
This is
you nerd doof.
Yeah, I'm not sure all he wants that gaming chair.
Go.
That is a beautiful game. Do you
the
sell
way
that?
Back.
Look at that.
Is that a gaming chair or a dental chair?
Looks like a beat off.
It's very
chair
similar.
That is exactly what it is, right? That's a gaming chair. Yeah.
It's a gaming chair. This is a Microsender branded gaming chair, yes.
Oh, really? You get discounts on the gaming chairs?
Yeah, got a pretty good discount because this is made by the company who's associated with Microsender.
That's a really nice chair. Is that as comfortable as it looks?
Oh, God, yes. Absolutely.
Yeah.
It doesn't look that comfortable. I think it looks too
narrow. What is wrong with you? What are you so anti-gaming chair for?
Yeah, I mean, if you do have broad shoulders, these little flaps will get in the way, but it fits me perfectly.
Mike, I'm anti-gaming chair because I come from a family of quality furniture.
Yeah.
And that is built to be disposable right there. You're looking
All I know is one of the most expensive chairs I ever bought, and I still have this tongue flap from where the staples came undone, and I don't believe any furniture is worth spending too much money for.
Thomasville.
And I know a lot of people say, hey, you got it. What is it?
Thomasville. Buy Thomasville, Mike.
Thomasville, you with your 700% markup.
Yeah, how about Haywood Wakefield? Also great.
Haywood Wakefield?
Haywood Wakefield, sure.
I've never heard of Haywood Wakefield.
They specialized in maple furniture. Beautiful stuff.
You want a solid Herman Miller. That's what you want.
Yeah.
Herman Miller.
Yes. Also great. Okay. Lane is out of business, I just found out, so you can't buy Lane anymore. Unless
Made
it's on
some
the-
good chairs, wooden chairs up in Maine. I got them from an antique sale one time.
Oh, that's excellent. Yeah.
Mm. I've got four dining room chairs up in Maine that are from a company where they were built in Maine. I don't know what it is.
It wasn't Sprague Carlton. It's another great
Spread Carlton.
Spread Carlton also made maple furniture.
That sounds like something you'd do in like an old sitcom. It's really dirty.
Let's get back to Mac.
All right. What kind of furniture do you like, Mac?
Well, I got some good. I actually did get a Lazy Boy,
Is that your lazy boy behind you?
That one right there, yeah.
Oh,
can we see it? Can we see it better?
I can bring you over, see this whole
take
place.
Take us around.
New pad, maybe we could explain something called artwork to you.
Because, Mike, we sold
I am lacking that currently, so let me...
What is that? Well, I just saw a claw, some sort of like medieval claw or something. Oh, look at the games.
DVDs?
So these are my... That's my bookshelf. But let me show you the chair first.
That's really going to be a panty dropper
is the
for
lazy
girl
chair.
Oh, look at that Lazy Boy.
You know
that's
what that looks
great.
Like? Believe Next it or not, couch. I might know the serial number for that because we sold Lazy Boys. That might be... Is it a swivel or is it just stay still?
It's a rocking. Yeah.
Okay, that's a 10-4-26.
Robb sold furniture in
a
previous life.
I understand that.
That's a nice sofa. Is that a new sofa?
New sofa. That came from Value City.
Good man.
Volva City.
I love Value City.
Table.
I went to Value City. I furnished some basement furniture and it ripped.
This is my video center.
Oh.
Can you zoom in on that, please? Can we see the titles?
Sure.
Is there any porn?
Sure. So let's go top to bottom on each one. So each shelf on this shelf is basically PlayStation.
Okay,
this is my PlayStation 1 shelf. Has the PlayStation 1 with all the games I had.
Okay.
Below it, PlayStation
it's like
2.
It's like a museum piece.
Yeah, and has all the games. Fits actually perfectly. Every single game fit with the PlayStation 2.
Nice.
Next shelf is just the set of all my favorite games of the Kingdom Hearts series.
Oh my God.
Wow, and then whatever that PlayStation is. 3 had two PlayStation 3s because one of them broke a few less games because a lot of times I would get them online.
Yeah.
Are you a PS guy? Are you a Sony PlayStation guy? Is that your...
Always. Yeah. Never.
What the hell is that? Is that like a colonoscopy machine down there? What the hell is that?
This is, on the right side is my PlayStation 4 stuff, but on the left side and down here is my flight simulator gear.
Ooh. Oh, wow. Now I am impressed with that. So, all right, take me. There's a little orange dial that, zoom in on that a little bit. Is that the gas pedal? I mean, the gas for the plane?
The throttle?
The throttle?
This one, yeah, this, the one on the left and the right are both throttles, or two different throttles. I use them interchangeably depending on which plane I'm flying.
And Mike, right above it, if you look carefully, you can see his ventilator.
Do you have a flight mask?
Iron lung.
We should explain that what he has just shown us is a modular styled bookshelf, and every shelf is dedicated
to
a different gaming platform. And I think it's fantastic.
The Billy bookshelf from IKEA.
All right, use your shaking hand to point at what everything is. Show me. That's the first throttle.
That's a throttle. This is also a throttle, but it has a lot more interchangeable buttons. Mm-hmm. So,
which one do you hook up to your junk?
Yeah, it goes up.
The virtual stewardess.
See, I'd love to have a flight simulator.
This is joystick. This poor kid. Joystick.
He's not a put. This is a young man who's out on his own.
He could
have spent all
that money on all those shelves and at least purchased three or four different escorts. He would have been A-okay.
Yeah, and a painting.
Okay.
Today you are
down
a man.
Here. Jesus. This is my yoke. The most expansive thing.
Expansive.
Which can go in, can go out, but it will pull out of the shelf. Left, right.
All right. So, what do you hook that yoke up to? Do you put your penis?
All into my computer. It runs the game Microsoft Flight Simulator. It's one of the most realistic flight simulators I've ever seen.
Top 10, to be sure.
So, let me ask you this question, because I am fascinated by the video game flight simulator. So, do you have a dedicated computer just to your flight simulator?
Oh, God, yes. Well, not just to that. This is my beast of the computer that runs everything.
Okay.
It's got full RGB and everything.
How much do real balls cost? Or those Island Beauties?
I'd have to ask him. I forget the price point. Yeah.
Oh, you mean a love doll?
Yeah, for him.
Remember the Island Beauties?
Mac. So you know how much if somebody really wants? So where do you hook up your yoke? Like on that table?
It actually has right here. Let me grab it.
I'm a little bit of a geek, guys, when it comes to flight simulators.
This is what holds it in place. You clamp it in.
Oh, onto the desk.
So cool.
Holds it in place. Yeah. Also,
where do you put the hand lotion?
This desk.
Shut up. I'm trying to watch him do it. I'm into this. Stop it.
This desk does raise into a standing desk.
Is it waterproof?
You guys, they suck, Mac. I'm totally into this.
Mike, it's amazing. Every hair was placed into the head one at
now
a time.
Now it's a standing desk. So I absolutely love this desk. Also from IKEA.
Yeah. How much do you think to get a real, all those flight simulator things, how much is the investment?
I probably spent about $400 on all those parts.
So $400 gets you the whole thing.
But not the computer.
Not the computer.
You
like
can get it
grand
for
on the
a lot
computer.
Cheap.
Two
I mean, the main the things that you need. So the yoke that I got comes with the black, blue, and red throttle system. So that those come together. I got this separate because I liked it better. And so that was about
Oscar and Rob aren't into this. I am.
He's making it seem like he's a pilot.
Yeah. You're not the whole
reason I want to be a pilot.
That's the question I have. Do you think you fly like a 737, things like that, a Gulfstream, right? You fly all these on the simulator?
I'm not skilled enough to do it.
What do you fly?
I've started with like small Cessnas. Just
so, do you think you could get into the cockpit of a set? What do you want? What are you doing? What are both of you
the
doing?
The whole point of flying is to fly the big boys, not to jump in the Cessnas.
Exactly.
Well, you got to start somewhere.
All right. So, if you're flying these, could you get into the cockpit? Do you think and make a go of it if your instructor had like a heart attack?
Oh, absolutely. A Cessna, yes.
What if you were flying to like Comic-Con, and they
I'm on the loudspeaker.
Mac, do we have a pilot?
There's been
make
food
some time
poisoning.
For us, Mac. We got to leave you because we've run out of show. But when we come back, can we come to your house again and talk to you?
Sure. Absolutely.
Because we're running out of time. And there's the TV.
Can he show us one more thing before we jump off? Like, what
yes,
do you want to show
Oscar,
us?
He can. Yeah. He can, of course.
What do you want?
Dealer's choice. You tell
the
me.
Shoes by the door. The shoes by the door.
The shoes by the door.
Are those
Let
heels?
Me see the shoes
I
by the door.
I mean, I can show the bedroom.
Please show us the shoes by the door.
Yeah, save the bedroom for next
time. It's got my dress shoes, my moccasins, and my sandals.
That's great. And you know, Mike, if he's a good boy, Santa fills them with candy.
We love you, man.
Let me just do a quick once over of the whole place.
Okay.
So, okay. All right. Very
here
good.
Is living room area.
Correct.
Right next to it, dining room area.
Nice.
Right.
And then back here is a window to the kitchen.
Mm-hmm. Can we see in your
kitchen.
Refrigerator, please? Can
Order
we see
up?
In your
sure.
refrigerator?
Classic sure. bit. Right, May we All see right, your refrigerator,
go.
Please?
Okay. All right.
Here we go.
All right. Let's see. What do we have
Ta-da.
Here? What are those beverages?
Dr. Pepper Zero sugar and Cherry Coke Zero sugar.
Nice.
What's to the left of the? What are the green bottles?
Sprites.
Sprite simulator.
Yeah, Sprite simulator.
And Mike, just below it, one human yes. head.
Yes, there it is.
Yeah, we got some leftover pizza Shock. Up top.
Nice.
Some leftover rice, jelly.
Man.
All my standard butter.
Jelly?
And
isn't jelly
condiments.
Always leftover technically?
I can't believe it's not butter.
Yes. Gatorade.
Yeah, boy, a lot of fun.
Come on over to Mac's house for dinner. We're having jelly and rice and Sprite.
Let's see the bathroom.
Bathroom?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
This is
getting
one of
a little
the
blurry
best
there.
New
there.
Things.
You,
yeah,
you not take your trying. Meds, it's getting blurry.
All right. Maybe I'm not taking
so this
mine.
This is my new shower curtain that I got.
Ooh.
Oh, well, what's let's that? See. What's that?
It's Japanese waves.
Oh, look at you with your zen life.
Now, do you actually take a shower? Or do you do a shower simulator?
It's beautiful.
Let me get back. The connection's going away.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. All right, hold
let
on.
Let me get closer to the router.
That was that. We didn't see the bedroom.
Oh, ladies.
Oh, my goodness.
Yummy.
There's the bedroom.
Dresser, another bedroom. TV.
Nothing says I want to have sex than a folding chair.
Yeah.
That's temper. That's going away shortly.
Yeah.
Okay.
When you're in the bedroom, where do you clamp the yoke?
We got to go, Mac. We got to go
Mac.
On that note.
We love you.
Thank you.
We'll see you.
We love you,
love rats,
you.
Man.
Bye.
Thank you, buddy. We'll talk to you soon. Thank you. That's Mike McIntosh. That was fun.
Well worth it.
Oh, should have spent more time with that. We'll get him back on.
Yes, absolutely.
Find out. Oh, listen, because I have many questions because he appears to be living in a basement.
Again.
We'll take a break, and we'll come back with something else. I don't even know where I am.
Country driving you loco on the Cattle Drive to Work Show. Good morning, America. It's me, Chuck Wagon, on Spiewak County's Best Country, playing the country hits while you're spraying your stinky pits. Have you ever thought about being a KTMOS talking head? Well, have you? Well, partner, it's easy to do. Just drop us a note at Robb@MikeOmaraShow.com. That's Robb with two B's, doo-dah. Tell us why you'd be a great talking head, and be sure to include your phone number, and don't forget your name. Oh, what's my name? Fuck you, that's my name. Here's Buck Owens.
You don't know me, but you don't like me.
There he goes. Welcome back to the Mike O'Meara Show, everybody. This portion of our program brought to you by KiwiCo. You know, we all know this school year is going to be different. Oh, I'll tell you about that in a second. You might even be schooling from home. And as parents, it can be time-consuming to give your kids the extra help they might need. So here's a bit of help. KiwiCo can deliver a science fair project or an art class right to your door. Hands-on education you're going to love. Cultivate your child's natural creativity and curiosity with new hands-on projects every month. They'll explore new worlds and rediscover familiar ones without leaving home. Michael loved building his own kaleidoscope, everything from sailing the solar system. He loved his sun, earth, and moon lantern.
So cool.
To engineering a drip irrigation system. Do your part to encourage your children to be innovators and creative thinkers. We need them now more than ever. There's no commitment, so you can pause or cancel anytime. And the best part, watching their confidence grow as big as their smile. KiwiCo is is redefining learning with hands-on projects that build confidence, creativity, and critical thinking skills. There's something for every kid or kid at heart at KiwiCo. Get your first month free on select crates at kiwico.com/TMOS. That's KIWICO.com/TMOS. And latest update down here. Didn't want to lead with it because I was simply too disappointed today. Right. The nonstop battle against protecting children from getting this horrible virus continues here in Florida, and an appeals court upheld the governor's wishes to prevent the mask mandate. And so now the superintendent of schools last night sent a letter to all of us saying that children can now opt out again if their parents wish them to. And so it's back to where it was. There are a few changes where the it's horrible. We sent our child to school today.
Yeah.
And there are kids in there because it has become a political thing. And where this happened, I don't know. I always talk about looking back and thinking about how history will judge this time. But
I think it's going to be pretty clear that a international, worldwide, tragic situation was weaponized and used to split the electorate.
Yeah.
And that's not okay. It's not okay. And so much damage was done that even with a reversal of the head of state, it's going to take a lot of undoing to do. And it's so clear how we could have fought it. Mm-hmm. And when there is even if the percentage that opposed it was smaller, we have to be together to move forward.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, Mike, I almost look forward to seeing 50 years from now, if we possibly could, how this is regarded. And it was like, it was very
well, in order for me to see that, I would have to be a monster. I would have to crawl out of the ground from my grave. But
it might not take 50 years, because as we discussed on the bonus show, that documentary about 9/11 was 20 years ago, and we have a different view of that now than we do then. So maybe 20 years from now, we can look back on this with some clarity.
That means nothing right now.
You're right, but
it means
I'm just
nothing
saying.
Right now. God willing, in 2 weeks, Mike, the FDA will give emergency authorization, from the reports I'm seeing, for 5 to 12-year-olds to take the Pfizer vaccine, for it to be available for those children.
It's not really easy to describe the feelings of a parent. And I have to say this, the people that got so angry at the school board and were calling them demons.
Yeah.
I don't feel that way, because I know that they're dealing with trying to follow the law. I really do believe that. I think that, they're afraid of they have jobs to do. They don't want to lose their jobs. I understand how there are threats, and the other side is trying to do everything legally and intimidatingly possible to get this thing pushed through because of what is called the Parents' Bill of Rights, where it is determined that the parents know best and that public health is taking a backseat to this. So my wife and I are we're in the throes of this, and we don't know where to go.
I think the underlying tone of the Parents' Bill of Rights is people like getting their way, and that's not fair.
Well, you can't even buy your way out of this.
It's going to go to the Supreme Court.
Yeah,
so I think on the letter from the superintendent, but it's, he talks about, I still hope that people will wear masks and blah, blah, blah. But at the same time, when you read that, it kind of rings hollow because everybody should do what why should people be encouraged to do their part when the leader of the state is not doing his part?
Exactly.
It's a scary thing, and it's not political, guys. This is not. It's been made political, but this is just one layer of protection.
That's all.
For a child. Mm-hmm. For a child. God, wrap your head around it. It doesn't make sense. So I go drop him off, and thank God the kids in his neighborhood, all the kids at the school bus, were masked up.
Good.
God love them. And he said 6 kids in his class of 20-something do not wear masks, including his best friend. And so I don't know whether that's the kid doing this or whether I don't know. I'm not going to get into that. That's not what I'm into. But it's a I can't describe the feeling. It's
helpless.
A feeling of total helplessness, you know, and why this had to be this way. I will never know. I guess I don't know. I can't talk about it. I'll get emotional because it's where we are. And we have more riots coming in D.C. Oscar. That's going to be coming too in our crazy land that we live in right now.
No, we'll get the fences the day after tomorrow. And they're prepared for what they're calling a small, brief rally to protest the people that are being punished for the first rally, the insurrection, on January 6th. And it is a scary flipping time to be here that they're planning for this.
Well, because this is on the heels of the first time in my lifetime that I ever felt like unsafe with the thought of the ability to demonstrate and march in this wonderful city.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right? It's weird.
I'm like,
it's
a weird time. And I literally looked at Shannon and I was like, I don't want to be alarmist, but do you think we should go to my mom's, just want to deal with this nonsense?
Yeah.
It's crazy.
You know, there have been protests in D.C. forever.
Yeah.
And, you know, I think it's going to hopefully be confined to a certain area. But once again, the first responders, the guys that are on the job, Park Police, D.C. Metro Police,
Capitol
Secret
Police.
Service, all the people that have to be there. My thoughts are with those guys and gals that are going to be dealing with that. Is it this weekend?
Saturday. Just for further context, we work with a handful of 60 Minutes contractors that specifically work for CBS 60 Minutes. And then when they can, they'll moonlight with us.
Mm-hmm.
And talking to one of the gentlemen yesterday, he said, you know, this is the first time where he would think of wearing his flak jacket.
Mm-hmm.
When he would be out shooting news. But this is the first time he doesn't even think about it. He's like, it's coming. Because you don't know what's going to happen now.
Yeah.
Weird world. Weird times.
It is.
It continues. So sorry about that. Mm-hmm. I had to get that off my chest.
True,
and maybe we'll have more on that as time goes on up in D.C. as you guys get ready for that. And lots more fun. We didn't even get a chance to talk about, are you ready for some football? Anyhow, we'll take a break and we will come back with the, are we at the digital dumpster portion
dumpster
of the program?
Double D. Dumpster.
Yeah. What the hell happened to this show? We'll take a break, come back with Robb right after this on the Mike O'Mara Show.
The Mike O'Mara Show.
Probably have a couple beers.
TMOS.
2, 3, 4.
A full-bodied podcast.
Sometimes wine.
With earthy tones of pop culture and a bouquet of comedy, wit, and sarcasm.
Do you drink every night, Pony?
Yeah. I'll have a martini about 5 o'clock.
The Mike O'Mara Show.
Sometimes 4 to 6 beers.
A drinking show.
4 or 5 drinks.
With a radio problem.
How am I alive?
Watch the live feed weekdays at MikeOMaraShow.com or download it wherever you get your podcasts.
Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. This portion of our program brought to you by Nutrafol. When it comes to thinning hair, you no longer have to choose between natural remedies and those that work. There's a holistic solution for men that promotes both healthier hair and whole body wellness without drugs or prescriptions. Did you know that there are 5 root causes of thinning hair? Nutrafol is the hair supplement that goes beyond genetics to target stress hormones, nutrition, metabolism, and environmental factors that may be impacting your hair.
Yeah.
Nutrafol is clinically shown to improve hair growth, thickness, and visible scalp coverage without compromise. 21 potent.
They're actual.
P-O-T-E-N-T. Potent.
2.
Potent natural ingredients also support sex drive, better sleep, and less stress. In a clinical study, men showed progressive improvement in hair growth and thickness after 3 and 6 months. Nutrafol is also trusted and recommended by more than 1,500 top doctors. You can grow thicker, healthier hair and support our show by going to Nutrafol.com and entering the promo code TMOS to save $15 off your first month subscription. This is their best offer anywhere, and it's only available to U.S. customers for a limited time. Plus, free shipping on every order. Get $15 off at Nutrafol.com, spelled Nutrafol.com, promo code TMOS. Now let's get over and open this thing.
Yes, please, open it up.
Want to see who's in there down at the bottom. Hello?
Hey, baby, welcome on in here to the Wolfman. Yeah,
night.
Oh, Wolfman.
Wolfman
Jack.
And you missed yesterday, Mike. Rod Roddy was visiting. No, he was in the dumpster yesterday.
Yeah.
Oh, he was in the dumpster.
Yeah, he was not visiting. He was in there.
Yeah, because he's dead.
He is dead. He is dead. Yeah. And that's the Wolfman was one of my favorite Halloween costumes you ever did.
Oh, that's right. I wore the black Kiana shirt. And
yeah.
I jet blacked my, and it was something where I could pull it off, and I jet blacked my hair, and I was just like, I clap for the Wolfman.
He's great.
We'll dig him to the day you die.
Legendary. Yeah, all right.
You want a popsicle?
All right. Oscar, have you ever seen American Graffiti?
No.
You should see it. It's a great film.
Popsicle.
And the Wolfman plays himself in it.
Well, no,
I've seen.
Well, I had to look it up the first time you guys talked about him.
Oh, okay, so you've seen that scene.
Yes. And I know that
Ron Howard is in it.
Got a great soundtrack.
Cindy Williams.
He's got a baby Harrison Ford in it.
Mm-hmm. Charlie Martin. Yeah. And of course, Richard Dreyfuss, my buddy.
Richard Dreyfuss.
They drive up and down the street, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. All right. Yeah. Mike, one of my nerdiest traits that I've had my entire life, and there's plenty to pick from, but I've always collected radio jingles. And it's fun because I'm a radio guy, and every now and then I hear one I've never heard before. And Jeff Mason, a radio buddy of mine that I worked with in Pennsylvania when I had that job at that Top 40 station when a million years ago, he's a bigger jingle collector than I am, and he sent me this based on yesterday's show. We're talking about what Oscar buys at Wawa. And this jingle, Mike, this is a classic. This is a top 10 one of all time.
These pretzels are making me thirsty.
And that is the true Jam 7 voice sound out of Dallas, Texas. And he worked at a 90s themed station.
Cool.
So they had these jingles made.
These pretzels are making me thirsty.
Yeah, baby.
Love it.
Jingle time.
So Monday Night Football on the heels of a great Sunday Night Football game. Last night's Monday Night Football game. Mike, it went into overtime.
So much fun to watch.
They thought the Ravens might be able to pull it off, but at the first game ever played with an audience in Las Vegas, Nevada, because of COVID last year, the Ravens pulled it off.
Second
and
four.
Blew
no,
it.
No, no, stop. Stop.
The Ravens
you
blew
it. Up.
I did.
You messed it
He's
up.
He's so non-football.
You're so terrible.
He's so non-sports.
Can I put it together just briefly?
Yes.
The Raiders look like they won in overtime. Like they were 27-27. They tied up. It was just you're like, oh my God. And then it looked like they won.
All they needed was a field goal, right?
No. Yeah, stop talking. You sound like an idiot.
Hold it. I want to just say this.
These pretzels are making me thirsty.
I sat there and I said, well, the Ravens put up a good fight. Didn't work out. I'm a Ravens fan. Let's move on. I said, okay, the Raiders won. There was a goal line interception. Went through the hands of the receiver, hit the helmet of a Ravens player, and then picked off. Okay, here we go. The Ravens, all they needed to do was score a field goal at this point. Didn't work out. They ended up fumbling.
So wait. Let me see, because I didn't watch the game.
Yes.
And I know there were two big comebacks.
Yes.
I know Kansas City, Patrick Mahomes brought them back against the Cleveland Browns.
Correct.
But as far as who intercepted who?
So David Carr threw a ball that went through his receiver's hands, butterfingers,
and the Ravens intercepted.
Yeah, their defense intercepted.
And they have to march down the field, and all they need to do is score
a field goal
to win.
That's it.
We'll win it.
Yes. Will they win it? They don't, because they fumble the ball.
So they intercept the ball, and then they fumble the
ball. Yes, and at this
point... But it was a daunting task to be probably... Did they recover the interception in the end zone?
Yes. So they
went
all the way to
20 yards.
So they went to
the 20-yard, and who fumbled?
The quarterback. Just like the Giants.
We're not the only ones.
So then you're like, okay, at this point, the Raiders, all they need is a field goal to win the game.
Wait a minute. You just said all the Ravens needed was a field goal.
Yes, but then they fumbled the ball.
Is the game tied at this point?
Yes, tied.
Overtime tied at 27.
So they're both trying to win the game.
Yes. Correct.
So
the Raiders line up for a field goal to kick the ball.
Yes.
And then they have an offsides. So they get pushed back 5 yards.
Yes.
So then they line up again, but not for a field goal, but to get some yardage. And this is what happens.
They decide on fourth down to go for it.
I believe it was. I don't think it was.
No, no, they went for the kick early.
They wanted to just end the game.
Okay, so it's third down, and now they want to get the yardage.
Yes. It's overtime. They're tied at 27.
Second and 14. Yeah. Can't lose any yards here. Going to throw. Drake picked up the pressure. All alone is Zay Jones, and he will prance into the end zone.
Raiders win.
And the victory in overtime for the Raiders. And this celebration is for real.
Wow. Pretty good ending. Beautiful game.
Yeah,
wonderful
like
stadium.
It. Two great primetime games.
I hated that the Ravens had lost, but you sat there, you're like, man, what a game.
Don't forget, Thursday night, Loser Bowl.
Loser Bowl.
Loser Bowl. We've already got one. Washington football team against the New York Giants.
Well, this has been a football-rich yes. audio vault, so yes. let's close with this. I want you to know that Jeff Bezos is rumored and to be in talks to buy the Denver Broncos. Now, I think if he moves some numbers around in his budget, he can afford it. Experts say that if he were to buy every NFL team, he would be left with $90 billion. But that's only if he bought every team. So I right. play this tape as a salute to Jeff Bezos. Let us close with The Simpsons.
Oh, the Denver Broncos.
I think owning the Denver Broncos is pretty good.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, explain to me why it isn't.
You just don't understand football, Marge.
And that jackass just bought a soft serve ice cream machine for his kitchen. I hate Jeff Bezos. That's your digital dumpster. Have a good Tuesday, everybody.
That's it. We got to get out of here. Our thanks to Mike McIntosh for coming on the show. And thanks for my thanks to my mother-in-law for going in and getting that water out of the
creep show.
Out of the grocery Love store. It. That was and good photojournalism. Yeah.
She could watch that show Pinky in the Brain.
Yes, yeah. You can almost smell that picture, can't you? Anyway, we'll be back with a brand new episode tomorrow for Robb Speedwagon, Oscar Santana, Mike O'Mara saying so long, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Ciao, ciao.
Want more? Make sure you check out the Mike O'Mara Bonus Show. Get it at MikeO'MaraShow.com.
Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.
How would you like to be told that about your child?
He's minimally exceptional.
Oh, thank God for that.